Good evening on a Monday, and thanks for joining us. I'm Sophie Erber. Many people are worried about kids in the U.S. getting sick as vaccines are still not available for those under the age of 12. Our Washington correspondent, Basil John, reports now as plans are in the works to vaccinate this at-risk population, and it's our top story at 5.
Federal officials say the belief that kids are safe from COVID-19 is wrong.
The myth that children don't get sick is disproven by the facts.
Health and Human Services Secretary Xavier Becerra says there are a number of children who have been hospitalized by the virus and some have died.
Kids are part of the unvaccinated, right? You haven't been exposed to coronavirus in the past. And if you're not vaccinated, you're at risk of getting the bad complications of the viral infection itself.
Health experts like Dr. Claire Bogard with Children's National Hospital say even though kids handle the virus better than adults, there are many safety measures to take.
We really need to practice the social distancing, the wearing of masks, the hand washing, so that we can protect those more vulnerable.
Bogard says the fight against the virus could change in the next few weeks.
The FDA will be meeting to look at the data that Pfizer has presented on the 5 to 11-year-olds.
Bogard says the FDA may recommend a slightly smaller dose of vaccines for children, providing protection to the kids and those around them.
As a population, we will get closer and closer to that herd immunity that we've all been talking about.
After approval, it will be up to parents and guardians to take action.
Once we get the word that it's okay to vaccinate 5 to 11, let's take them and every child above the age of 11 to get vaccinated.
Reporting in Washington, I'm Basil John.
General Colin Powell, former chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff and Secretary of State, has died of COVID-19 complications at the age of 84. In an announcement on social media, the family says Powell had been fully vaccinated against COVID-19. Powell's aide says he was also being treated for blood cancer, but his family has not yet confirmed that. He was known for his role as George W. Bush's Secretary of State. He worked to address America's stance with Pakistan and Afghanistan following the events of 9/11. With COVID-19 cases again on the rise, doctors tonight are concerned the upcoming flu season could lead to what they're calling a twindemic. Experts are anticipating a hard-hitting flu season because of lower cases last year, making it that much more important for people to get their flu shots early before cases rise in your area. The CDC recommends you should have a flu shot before the end of October.
We encourage everyone to go out to get their flu vaccine, no matter what their age is, 6 months and older. We think that's probably one of the key things to limiting the number of cases and also the spread of it.
The CDC has also said you can have both the COVID-19 vaccine and the flu shot at the same time. A semi-truck driver has died tonight following a crash early this morning in Sioux City. That accident happened around 8 in the morning today on the 2800 block of 18th Street in Sioux City. Police say the semi veered off the road and struck a grove of trees. That driver was pronounced dead at the scene. Now, authorities tonight believe the driver was possibly suffering a medical issue prior to that crash. The driver's name has not yet been released, but authorities are continuing to investigate this accident. And new details have been released on a shooting that left an Emerson man injured over the weekend. Sioux City police say 44-year-old Gary Wendt was at a home in the 2600 block of Douglas Street to purchase drugs. Authorities say the man he met there tried to rob him. During that robbery, he was shot in the stomach and later driven to Unity Point Health St. Luke by a friend. Police say they know who shot him but have not filed charges because of Wendt's limited cooperation. A Sioux City man will spend the next 20 years behind bars, this in connection to a shooting that happened back in July of this year. 19-year-old Tyron Mallory had been sentenced to 25 years in prison for shooting a man back on July 28th, again in Sioux City. Mallory pled guilty to willful injury, going armed with intent, and reckless use of a firearm. An attempted murder charge was dropped as part of his plea agreement. According to the latest court documents, Mallory admitted to shooting a transient man multiple times. A Des Moines man who remains jailed for failing to give up on conspiracy theories after taking part in the January 6th U.S. Capitol riot will be back in court next month. Doug Jensen was arrested days after that riot, and pictures of him and video leading to a charge through the Capitol were released. Jensen told authorities he took part due to his adherence to QAnon's conspiracy theories. He was released from jail in July of this year and then arrested weeks later for violating his release terms. That's when he was caught watching conspiracy theory videos online. He will be back in court at the end of November. If convicted, he could be facing up to 20 years in prison. And it's time now to turn our attention to the Weather Department. Chief Meteorologist Scott Larson standing by. Scott, kind of a roller coaster in temperatures yesterday, a beautiful fall day. Today, again, but with a little bit more wind.
Yeah, we had a breeze out there today, Sophie, but all things considered, it was really nice for the month of October. Usual highs are just above 60 degrees, and this afternoon, we were able to top things off in the middle to upper 70s, including a high of 76 in Sioux City. It shouldn't be quite as cool out there tonight as low temperatures fall to about 50 in the area. Tomorrow, it looks like high temperatures will rise back into the mid and upper 70s, but you'd see that we will have a cooling trend as we get into Wednesday and Thursday, along with a chance of showers. We'll have more information on that. Stay tuned for the full forecast. Sophie.
All right. Thanks a lot, Scott. With workers leaving their jobs at a record pace tonight, Siouxland businesses are trying to get creative to come up with ways to keep people from walking out. Nearly 4.3 million people quit their jobs in the month of August alone in the United States. It's mostly in retail, food and beverage services, but some are referring to this time as the Great Resignation. Jim Stein with Advanced Services Incorporated here says there are multiple reasons for the shortage and also various incentives that employers are trying to offer to combat the drop in applications. Our reporter Mallory Smith will share just what some of the businesses are offering to keep workers. That's coming up tonight right here at 10. If you're hoping to get your car fixed, it might take longer than you would like. Siouxland is still seeing a shortage in car parts. Local repair shops say they've tried ordering the parts from a variety of sources to speed up repair times. Martin Gruce is a shop foreman at Woodhouse Service and Parts, and he says the shortage impacts more people than just mechanics.
Makes it difficult, mainly for the customer. You know, anytime a customer has to wait 3 months for a part, it's awfully difficult. You know, we do everything we can to provide alternative transportation, expedite the parts, you know. Every angle you can try and do to try and help the customer, that's what it comes down to, really.
Tonight, some of the hardest parts to get are electronics, whereas some of the easier parts are brakes and suspensions. The opening weekend of the South Dakota pheasant hunting season has officially come to a close. Executive Director Dan Lettler says that roughly 1,800 pheasant hunters flew into the Sioux Falls Regional Airport both Thursday and Friday. The pheasant hunting industry generates more than $200 million every year for the South Dakota economy. Returning hunter Sid Farmer made the trip from South Carolina and hunted out at Sergeant Ranch Lodge, that's just northwest of Pierre, this weekend.
Got a lot of birds, hit our limit every day, had a blast. Sergeant Ranch is kind of a all-inclusive thing, so they, you know, we fly into Sioux Falls. We drove up, some of the guys flew into Pierre and they just picked them up, but it was a great time.
This was Farmer's seventh year hunting in the state of South Dakota. He says his group has already booked its stay for next October. Now, while opening weekend has already come and gone for the state, those of you in Nebraska and Iowa will have to wait a couple more weeks to head out into the fields. Well, are you planning to travel this holiday season? A lot of people are, and if so, you might be facing significant turbulence, and not while you're up in the air. We'll explain what the TSA vaccine mandate could cause you coming up.
And nothing turbulent expected on our Tuesday. In fact, it should be terrific outside tomorrow, but some wet and windy conditions take over on Wednesday, and it looks like that'll pave the way into a cooler and more seasonal pattern as we approach the end of the week. Join us for the full forecast. That's next.
You're watching KCAU 9 News with Sophie Erber and Chief Meteorologist Scott Larson. This is KCAU 9 News at 5.
Thanks for sticking with us. A beautiful sunny day, but depending on where you were, if you couldn't seek shelter in the afternoon, the wind might have hit you and made it feel chillier than it was.
Yeah, the wind was whipping around out there today, Sophie. We had some gusts exceed 30 miles per hour at times. As we look outdoors on the Wayne State College camera set up in northeast Nebraska, bright sunny skies above and what has been a really nice October day. Here's the almanac for Sioux City. It shows our high temperature was 14 degrees above the normal high of 62, the morning low temperature at 39. So we've been enjoying some warmer than average temperatures. It looks like this will last for one more day before some changes start to work in on Wednesday. Right now, the temperature is 75 degrees outside. The wind is ushered in from the south at 15 miles per hour with a relative humidity of just 23%. The air is dry with a dew point of 35 degrees. Temperatures are hovering hovering between 70 and 75 for most of our Siouxland map right now. It is currently 74 out there in Wayne, 75 for Sioux City. Enjoying a temperature of 72 in Orange City and Cherokee. Happen there. As we go into the weekend, we'll bounce back a bit with a high of 62 on Saturday. Another chance of some showers next Sunday. And then in the extended forecast, we might be able to pop off a couple of 70-degree high temperatures next Tuesday and Wednesday. Keep sending in those pictures to us at weather@kcautv.com. When you do so, we'll send you a form, fill it out real fast, send it back to us, and we'll show your pictures on TV.
We've just had a warm start to fall that we've been really spoiled. We should be closer to 60s than 70s right now.
Yeah, the average high temperature is 62, so we've been far exceeding that, and it looks like Tuesday is going to follow suit.
All right, thanks a lot, Scott. Well, is visiting a haunted house on your list this fall season? If so, there's one drawing thousands of people into Chicago. We'll take you inside. Coming up, but first, travel issues from the ground up, why the vaccine mandate for TSA workers could affect your holiday plans next. Americans are bracing for a potentially turbulent travel season. A vaccine deadline for TSA workers is just weeks away now, and with many employees still unvaccinated tonight, TSA officials say they're preparing for a possible staffing shortage this season. Reporter Haley Hendricks has the details.
President Joe Biden says vaccine requirements are helping to curb the spread of COVID-19, but more shots need to go into arms.
We have to do more to vaccinate the 66 million unvaccinated people in America. It's essential.
Transportation Security Administration, also known as TSA workers, are required to be fully vaccinated against COVID-19 by November 22nd, Monday before Thanksgiving. The agency says 4 in 10 employees remain unvaccinated. In an interview with CNN, TSA Administrator David Pekoski says he's hopeful people will meet the deadline. But if not, they're creating contingency plans in the case of some staffing shortages. Flying from LAX to Salt Lake City, Presley Regeer and Jake Lenthal say if fewer people are working, it could cause some delays for holiday travel.
Long lines definitely be a bummer, but I mean, I guess they got to do what they got
to
do.
I think the priorities need to be set, but at the same time, it might minimize the amount of like family that gets to come out to visit for Christmas or different holidays.
Even with the vaccination deadline 6 weeks away, it's now too late for employees to get Moderna's vaccine. However, employees would need to get Pfizer's shot by October 18th or Johnson & Johnson's vaccine by October 29th.
Well, News Nation Prime gathers news from across our country at 8 every night. But before that, Leland Vitter and Dan Abrams break down today's hot topics, and we have a preview.
Tonight, China taking the world by surprise, what they're denying and why the U.S. didn't see it coming. Plus, a new casualty of the supply chain crisis, the unlikely reason wine might disappear from store shelves. That's coming up on Balance Tonight. Now here's a look at tonight's Banfield.
Tonight on Banfield, a frightening case of mistaken identity in the Bryan Laundry manhunt. U.S. Marshals burst through the door of an Appalachian Trail hiker, holding him at gunpoint. And he's not the first to be wrongly ID'd. That's tonight on Banfield.
Again, News Nation Prime comes your way every night at 8, 7 Central on News Nation. You could catch it on some of the channels listed here, or if you're interested, check your local guide. Well, if haunted houses are your thing, there is one in the Windy City attracting visitors from across our country. We'll show you why when we come back. Haunted houses are making a return this year, you might have noticed, after many took a year off because of the pandemic. It takes a lot to put one on, and especially if it's one of the premier Halloween destinations in one of America's largest cities. Marcella Raymond takes us inside.
At every turn, there's a terrifying monster just waiting to make you jump and cringe. The 13th floor haunted house in Schiller Park is definitely not for the faint of heart.
What can people see when they come in?
Their absolute worst nightmares. We have two different attractions. One is like a post-apocalyptic dark version of Chicago, and that's the bad blood theme this year. And then where we are right now is the spirit of Halloween. It's a very twisted, whimsical, very old school Halloween vibe.
How can you be twisted and whimsical at the same time?
Gotta come to 13th floor Chicago and find out.
It takes time to make up these actors so they can scare the heck out of you.
Because the haunted house is super dark and the makeup is dark, I want to be able to highlight those features on her. So when she's walking through the house and you see her, you're going to see everything dark, but I want some parts to stick out. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to highlight those areas.
The result is a possessed nun who likes to just stand around and basically creep you out.
I'm moving over this way, and I think I might be dead soon. And she kind of looks like me if I were, you know, in Dawn of the Dead or something. I'm gone.
It takes about 15 minutes to get through the house, and you might want to hang on to someone, you know, just in case. Brian, I'm just going to hold on to you for the next couple of minutes. Seriously. Knock it off. 13th floor is recommended for kids over 12. It's really pretty terrifying, though, and not just because I'm a scaredy cat. And you know what I love is their faces are painted so well, but it's their movements and the sounds they make that freak me out the most.
Creepy. We take a live look outside right now. Clear skies over Cherokee. Scott returns right after this break with one more check on your forecast. Don't go away. Before we wrap up at 5, we do a quick check-in for what's coming up right here on the desk at 6. First, if you have a vehicle requiring some mechanical repairs, we dive deeper into why auto shops we talked with say get ready for a serious waiting game. Local mechanics say a wide variety of parts are just hard to come by, and it's taking a toll on their repairs. Our reporter Nick Wilson has the full details coming up at 6. Speaking of cars, self-driving vehicles like those produced by Tesla are growing in popularity, we know, but now companies might be turning to self-driving semis, really FedEx, one of those companies in the testing stages. We'll show you what it all means for the trucking industry. That's coming up after World News Tonight in just about a half hour. That'll be an interesting story and a beautiful weather for driving, although if you are in one of those top-heavy vehicles, you probably felt the wind today.
Yeah, I have to drive with some caution out there due to the breeze that we have in place, Sophie. Expecting to see the wind settle down some as we go into our Tuesday, a really nice one with a high temperature of 76 and a mostly sunny sky. It looks like some showers will work in on Wednesday. We can expect to see our temperatures fall into the 50s and 60s after that. Another chance of showers pops up next Sunday with a strong breeze once again, but it looks like we'll hit highs in the 70s later on.
All right, thanks, Scott. Thank you for joining us. We'll all see you here tonight at 6 with Tim and Jake. Until then, have a great evening, everyone.